हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल इलेक्ट्रिकल बूस्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस और गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम दैट रिलेटेड टू मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसफर थ्योरम। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट। हियर द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन दैट फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ आरएल फॉर द गिवन नेटवर्क फ्रॉम दिस नेटवर्क दैट द पावर इज मैक्सिमम। ओके, हियर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गिवन दैट फाइंड दिस आरएल वैल्यू when the maximum power can be delivered, okay, and also find the maximum power through this RL, okay, by using maximum power transfer theorem, okay. Here see, the question asks to find this RL value and find the maximum power through this RL, okay. In our maximum power transfer theorem, we know that the maximum power is equal to how much? VTH square divided by 4 RTH. Okay, this is the maximum power through the load resistance. Okay, or one condition is RTH equal to RL. Okay, so that we need to find Thevenin's equivalent resistance or Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay, resistance and Thevenin's equivalent voltage. So that we already know about how to find Thevenin's equivalent voltage. Okay, for finding VTH, we need to open circuit the load resistance. The procedure finding the VTH, open circuit the load resistance and as remains same. Okay, so I open this load resistance, okay, this is 5 ohm and this is 12 ohm as you same. Okay, next this is how much? 8 ohm. Okay, this is 6 ohm. Okay, this is 6 volt. Okay, here we need to find value of VTH. Okay, here VTH means voltage drop across this 5 ohm. Okay, if we find voltage drop across 5 ohm, then we can find voltage across this. Okay, for finding voltage drop across 5 ohm, we need to find current in this form. Let this current is I1. Okay, for finding this current, we need to find this current. For finding this current, ID. So, first we need to find this current. This current means this I equal to total voltage by R equivalent. Okay, so we need to find R equivalent. Here we see, for finding R equivalent, this two is series because this is open, so this two is series, okay, and this is parallel. So R equivalent is equal to, I am directly write R equivalent equal to, see, this is 12 plus 5 parallel with 8 ohm. This 12 plus parallel with 8, then series with 6. Okay, so for this is 70 into 8 divided by 70 plus 8 plus 6, this is equal to how much? This is equal to 11.44 ohm. Okay, 11.44 ohm. Then we need to find this I value. Okay, so that this I is equal to 6 divided by 11.44. okay, so that this total current is 0.524. I already calculate. Okay, so that ampere. Okay, then we need to find this I1. For finding this I1, we need to current division. We know about how to find current division. Okay, so I1 is the total current into opposite resistance, this much, this is 8 divided by sum of resistance, means 12 plus 5 plus 8, this is equal to 0.524 ampere into 8 by, this is 0.524 into divided by this is 70 plus 25. Okay, let's, this is equal to 0.1678 ampere. Okay, if you don't know current division rule, the link in the I button, please click and see the current division formula. You can also to find this voltage also find the KVL also apply. Here I am going to by current division method. Okay, like see we can we able to find this current I1, so that we can find the voltage drop across this 5 ohm. Okay, the voltage drop across this 5 ohm is equal to nothing but here I write, see carefully, here I am going to write. Okay, see the voltage drop across this 5 ohm, voltage drop across this 5 ohm is equal to how much, this I1 into this 5 ohm. Okay, this I1 into 5. Okay, so that the I1 is equal to, we find 0.1678. okay, so that this is 0.1678 into 5, that is equal to how much, it is equal to 0.8391 volt. Okay, you know if voltage drop across this 5 ohm is equal to VTH. Okay, because the potential difference between this point same. Okay, so that V 5 ohm is equal to VTH. So finally VTH equal to 0.8391 volt. Okay, this is the VTH. Then next step to find Thevenin's equivalent resistance. Okay, Thevenin's equivalent resistance. Okay, for finding here, see, for 1 minute. Okay, for finding RTH we need to deactivate the source. Here is, see, here the only source is present, voltage source. So for voltage source we know short circuit. Okay, short circuit and open the load. Okay, so we go to short circuit. Okay, then this is the resistor as usual. Okay, okay, this is 5 ohm. Okay, and this is, okay, let this is, okay, this is 12 ohm and this is 5 ohm. Okay, we need to short circuit this voltage source, short circuit. Okay, so we need to find RTH here. Okay, so see, first those two are in parallel. Okay, so for RTH directly write RTH equal to, those two are parallel, 6 parallel 8. Okay, then this R to 12 and plus 12, then this total is parallel with 5 ohm. Okay, then we write fine, then 6 6 into 8 divided by 6 plus 8 plus 12, then parallel with 5. Okay, so finally got 3.77 ohm. Okay, 3.77 ohm. Okay, we finally got, you already know about this, so we skip this method. Okay, so we find finally. Okay, then we first question is find to, here the question is given that to find at what value of RL we can transfer maximum power. Okay, this is the value of RL. Okay, that was to find to transfer maximum power. Okay, next we find how much power through the in the load, how much maximum power in the load. Okay, in the load. Okay, so see, we know for maximum VTH square divided by 4 RTH, this is equal to VTH equal to 0.8391 square divided by, this is 4 into 3.77. okay, this is finally equal to 3.77. okay, this is equal to 0.0466. okay, watt. okay, this is your maximum power through load. But we need to find maximum power delivered. How much power delivered? That is equal to delivered, that is equal to VTH square by 2 RTH. Okay, here the question given like this much. Okay, we need to extra 0.839 square, 2 into 3.77. okay, this is equal to 0.0933 watt. Here you see this much amount of power delivered to the load, but maximum power through the load is this much. So always a maximum power transfer theorem only 50% efficiency. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. If any doubt, please comment. Thank you.